Hello friends, I hope you like my videos. So today in this video we will discuss about the analytical instrument qualification as per the USP chapter 1058. So we'll brief about the how we need to perform the analytical instrument qualification as per this guideline, right? So friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. So now first we will discuss what is analytical instrument or equipment qualification, right? So here is the basic definition. That is, analytical instrument equipment qualification is the collection of documented evidence that an instrument or equipment performs suitably for its intended purpose, right? So basically the analytical instrument will be used to analyze the various pharmaceutical samples. It may include the raw material, in-process samples, finished products and stability sample, etc., right? So results obtained from these instruments shall be used to release the material and products, and also based on this product the quality of the product or material shall be ensured, right? So hence it is very important to qualify the analytical instrument to ensure that the instrument performance is satisfactory and instrument will not give any faulty results, right? So this is the basic requirement. That is why we need to perform the analytical instrument qualification. So now in this slide we will discuss the components of data quality. So in the USP chapter 1058, it is mentioned that how should be the components of data quality. So you can understand easily with this pyramid, right? So what should be the components of data quality, right? So first you will procure the instrument and perform the qualification activity to ensure the system performance is satisfactory and system is fit for the intended use, right? So use of qualified instrument in analysis contributes to confidence that the validity of generated data is based on the high quality, right? Next is analytical method validation. So whichever analytical instrument method you will be used to analyze the samples, that method should be validated. So the use of validated procedure with qualified analytical instrument will provide the confidence that the procedure will generate the test data of acceptable quality, right? Next is system suitability test. So in the system suitability test, you just verify that the system will perform in accordance with the criteria mentioned in the procedure, right? So these tests are performed along with the sample analysis to ensure that the system performance is acceptable at the time of the test, right? So for example, in the HPLC system, you use the SST solution to check the resolution, to check the peak symmetry, retention time and repeatability to ensure that the method is functioning correctly and consistently, right? So the next is quality control, check samples. So for this, a reference standard or calibration standard is used to calculate the result of unknown sample result. So QC check sample are analyzed along with the unknown sample as a part of the routine analysis to ensure that the analytical process is under control and producing the accurate result, right? So basically the system suitability test and quality control check sample ensure the quality of analytical results immediately before or during the sample analysis, right? So I hope you can understand this pyramid of component of data quality. So first, when you procure any instrument, that instrument should be qualified. Then analytical method validation you need to perform on that particular equipment, that qualified equipment, and then you need to perform the system suitability test and quality control check samples so that you can have a the generated data should have the appropriate and acceptable quality. So now in this slide we will discuss the instrument categories. So based on the complexity, the instrument are categorized into three groups, that is group A, group B and group C. And apart from this, risk assessment need also to be performed based on the complexity of the instrument to determine the qualification approach, right? So I'll make another video for this risk assessment. So let's discuss with the different categories of the instrument. So you can see in the group A, the group A are those instruments which has not any measurement capability, right? So there is no any measurement capability will be available for the group A, and it also does not require any calibration. So for example, of that instrument equipment in this group are magnetic stirrer, vortex mixer, heating mantle, etc. Now the group B. So group B instrument equipment may provide the measurement or an experimental condition that can affect a measurement. That means there should be some kind of reading or results. So it will generate some kind of data, right? So group B equipment instrument may require only routine calibration or preventive maintenance or performance check, right? So for example, for group B instrument equipment, that is balance, melting point apparatus, pH meters, hardness tester, refractometers, buffer furnaces, ovens, incubator, etc. So now group C. So instrument with a significant degree of computerization and complexity. So group C are those equipment which will be connected with the some kind of software, and there should be the computerization system and complexity of that instrument equipment, right? The conformance of these instruments to user requirement is determined by specific function test and performance test. So for example, the group C instrument equipment is high performance liquid chromatography, gas chromatography, IR spectroscopy, UV spectrophotometer, Malvern or laser based particle size distribution instrument or equipment, right? So now in this slide we will discuss the life cycle approach for analytical instrument qualification, right? So these are the following life cycle approach for the analytical instrument or equipment. So first you need to prepare the URS where you will define the end user requirements, right? Then second, you need to perform the design qualification to ensure the procured system is having the appropriate design to fulfill the intended use of the instrument, right? And then installation qualification to be performed to ensure the instrument is correctly installed and configured. And then after operation qualification to be performed, and operation qualification is required to perform to ensure the system is operated as per the their operational condition and as per the user requirement specification, right? Then after successful completion of the operation qualification, performance qualification should be performed to ensure the system performance is satisfactory, right? And then after standard operating procedure for operation and calibration of the instrument, that should be prepared, and that SOP should also be approved. And after the preparation and approval of this SOP, that training should be imparted to the respective users to train on that operation and calibration activities for that particular instrument or equipment, right? And if the instrument is no longer required, then it can be retired from the routine use. So these are the life cycle approach for the analytical instrument. However, if the analytical instrument is connected with some software, then computer system validation life cycle approach should also be followed, and validation approach for computerized system should be followed, and computer system validation activity should also be performed for those complex systems, right? So now in this slide we will discuss what kind of documentation required for qualification of instrument equipment based on the complexity of instrument or equipment, right? So you can see here are three columns, that is group A, group B and group C. And for group A, you can see URS is optional, TQ is optional, IQ is optional, OQ is optional, PQ is optional, standard operating procedure is optional, training is optional, and retirement procedure is not required. So for group A, all the deliverables and qualification approach is optional. It is based on the internal discussion or quality assurance approval. So you can take the decision that how you are going to perform the qualification activity. But as per the guideline, it is not required for the group A category of instrument or equipment, right? And for group B and group C, all these deliverables are required, and performance of that instrument equipment shall be ensured by following this life cycle approach, right? So for group B and group C, you need to prepare the URS, you need to perform the design qualification, and IQ, OQ, PQ should also be performed, and SOP and training approach should also be followed, right? And also the retirement procedure, if that instrument and equipment is no longer required, then you need to perform the retirement procedure also, right? So friends, this is all about the analytical instrument qualification as per the USP 105A. So thank you so much for watching the video.